Live from the Times Union Center, it's Levack and Goz on 104.5 The Team.
I'm going to start this interview the same way I started the one with Jimmy Patsos a little while ago, head coach Ali Jackson. Anything going on this weekend? Anything big?
Oh, any plans? Yeah. You could say that we have some plans for this weekend. I literally just ran here from practice, so I got my workout in for the weekend, so I'm good. But big game. Big game tomorrow night.
The other Albany Cup. There's two Albany Cups.
There are two of them, yes.
The Great Dane Ladies versus the Saints, and you are you're going to be 5 o'clock tip.
5 o'clock tip.
Right here, regardless of what you've read elsewhere.
Times Union Center. For last I heard, it was the Times Union Center. Yeah. So that's where I'm going to be. I hope the game's going to be there. Well, I mean, I've left tickets for everybody here, so yeah.
Well, and I'm teasing because I was on the Mothership website, ESPN mm-hmm. National, and they had the Rec Center.
I wouldn't mind if it was at the Arc, quite frankly. I mean, that's something that we're probably going to look to do down the road. I know there's some controversy over the men's game, and Joanna and I have talked about the future of our series, and we'll probably have to negotiate that this spring. But I know we would both, I don't want to speak for her, but we've talked about it continuing as a home and home. So, you know, for us, this is as much a away game as it is for anybody. So, you know, we like it down here. We especially like it when the fans show up for our game as well. We're not televised this year, so I encourage everybody to come down and see it live. But, yeah, it should be a good one. It was a good one last year. Went to overtime, lots of drama in the game, and hopefully we'll have another good game this year for our fans.
All right, you've been scouting out her team. What do the Great Danes do that might give you guys some trouble?
They're big. They're very big. They're very physical. They rebound the ball very well. Their size is going to be a problem. They basically start 4 post players with Bozy at the top with their size. And I expect them to probably sit in a zone against us. You know, so we're going to have to get into the gaps of the zone. We're going to have to find ways to score. We're going to have to rebound with them. But their size is definitely a problem.
Now, so if we asked Coach Mack, she would say that your speed is then, right?
Is that what she said?
No, we haven't had a chance to talk.
She got her phone. She doesn't
come talk to us as much as you do. So I'm just saying, like, if you're going to say it's their size, then is it going to be your speed and athleticism?
I hope so. Yeah, I hope so. We play an unconventional style with how we press and back to Blizzard, which is our matchup defense. And we throw in a lot more man-to-man this year than we have in years past. So we try to keep opponents off balance with what we're in. And they end up running zone offenses against us, our man-to-man, a lot. But, so I would hope that our speed and quickness would pose somewhat of an issue for them. But they're a very talented team. They have great tradition of winning, so you know we got our work cut out for us.
We had Asante Shivers, one of the players from Siena, on with us earlier, and I asked the question that does he feel it as a player that you get more excited? Does practice change for those type of players going into a rivalry game? I know it's different from the coaching side of it, but can you tell in practice if your players have felt more excited for this rivalry game on the way?
Well, yesterday we had a terrible practice, and today we had one of our best, so I'm not sure. You know, I think from what our seniors said in the circle after practice today, if that was any indication of where our team is at and where our leadership is at, then this game means something to them. And it should. You know, I think that's what's great about college sports. Rivalry games are so much fun to coach in, to play in. Everything gets, you know, more magnified. But that's fun. It's fun to see who rises to the occasion, who's good under pressure, you know, what coaching tiny little adjustments you can make in a game that could have an effect. Like, I don't know, when I was a player, like, my team was pretty good at NYU, and we had games where we would blow people out, and I just didn't like those games. I like the close games that, you know, you just had to step up in. Those are fun for me. I like that.
Coach Ali Jaques with us right now. So, Coach, you know, we joke about the men's game and everything else. One of the reasons it gets more pub is the war of the words between Will Brown and Jimmy Patsos. Why is the female side so much more able to coexist and not pick at each other?
Women are nicer.
Well worded, by the way.
Very good. Coexist and not pick on each other.
I'm mildly afraid of her. She knows that. I'm pretty careful how I say things. Way more afraid of her than Patsos.
I mean, do I have to create drama to get people interested in girls' basketball? Like, do we have to have, like, cat fights for people to want to come to our games?
I mean, it's a selling point. Now you can bring it up.
If you have a steel cage, people will come. Pro wrestling has shown that. So,
I mean, I really respect Coach Mack. I can say that. She was at Maryland when I was at GW, and I really respect her as a human being and as a person. I think she is good for the game of women's basketball. I hope I am as well. I think we have a different agenda in that we want to inspire young girls, you know, of any sport to, you know, be confident and reach for their dreams and, you know, and have opportunities. And, you know, that's what sports for me, like, I'm a child of Title IX. I wouldn't be here if that wasn't born the year that I was born, you know, and I was one of two girls on my soccer team until seventh grade. I played with boys. That's just how it was. And to see how women's sports has exploded, you know, across our country and the confidence that it gives women in general with everything that's going on in the world, I think it's great. And I mean, if we need to create fake drama, we could probably do that. I don't know. I just think, you know, you're going to see two really talented teams with two different styles who want nothing more than to beat each other. So what better drama in a game is there than that? Like, they want to rip our hearts out and win. We want to do the same. I'm not sure if I'm supposed to say this on the radio or not, but we compete just as hard as anybody else. And quite frankly, I've had my butt kicked for five years. Hopefully it's not going to be six. I mean, I've been on the losing end of this for 5 years, and I will not quit. I can promise our Saints fans, I will not quit until we get this thing done. When I got hired, they asked me what's going to take to beat Marist, right? That's all anybody asked me. How are you going to beat Marist? We got that done the last 2 years. We haven't beaten these guys yet. And I'd be lying if I said it didn't bother me. It drives me crazy. So one of these days, we're going to get it done. It might as well be tomorrow.
I love it.
I'm fired up now, too, you know? Let's go. I want to play for Coach Jack right now. Right, man. I just think about this now. We're already getting you in trouble. Let's get you in more trouble now.
Great.
All right? You're talking to Coach Mack about renewing the rivalry and what goes into that. Is there something that goes above you guys, the decision that's going to be made? Is that going to be a coexistence? Like, for instance, if your guys' rivalry continues, does that necessarily mean the men's rivalry is going to continue? What is that
like? I don't know the answer to that. I have talked to John D'Argenio about that, and you know, I think there's so much up in the air on the men's side right now. We liked the idea of keeping it as a doubleheader just because it's good for the community. And quite frankly, that's what Siena's about. I mean, we're about giving back to our fans and making opportunities for our fans to see us play. That's why I intentionally scheduled every non-conference home game on a weekend to try to build our fan base. You know, I think that's important. It's tough on a Thursday night to come out to a game. I get that, you know. So for me, this is a opportunity for our community to have a game for people in the community. So, you know, I understand the ins and outs of what they're dealing with. Maybe we have different problems on the women's side. Maybe we don't need to follow the men's model. I'm not sure. I just know that we were recruiting on the road this summer in July, and I sat down with Joanna, and I'm like, listen, I don't know what's going to happen on the men's side, but if you and I have anything to do with it, I'm not sure where you stand, but I would like to see this continue. I think it's good for girls basketball. I think it's good for the community. And she agreed. I don't know if she's changed her mind on that. I mean, we talked the other day about what can we do to get more fans at our game on Saturday, you know, so I don't know. We'll see.
Listen, if you guys are gonna be so adult about this, I just don't even know what we can do. I mean,
listen, you know, that doesn't mean that she doesn't want to kick my butt tomorrow. I know she does. Like, I know her background and how good she is, and she's won a national championship at Maryland. She's good. I mean, she's great, you know. But that's, if you can look each other in the eye and respect each other and treat each other respect and still compete as hard as you possibly can every second of that game, then you're doing your job, right?
Absolutely. No, I agree. I'm just saying it's to, you know, all this adult concept, it's foreign to the show.
You're going to get in trouble for saying that, all right? The other coaches are going to hear that, and they're going to start yelling at both of us.
Oh, you don't think Will Brown and Jimmy Patsos know every once in a while they get a little sandbox going on? You don't think? I mean, come on.
Of course they do.
You guys don't have to agree. It's fun, and I love it. Don't get me wrong.
That's true. That's exactly right. We found out earlier in the show, by the way, that Coach might be able to take out DMX. Like, you were surprised to find out that DMX is not very tall. Who's going to be performing here at the TU later tonight?
Oh, I don't know. My team challenged me to freestyle on the radio with you guys about
do it,
where my dog's at or something. I'm like, I don't know that that's my talent, so I'm going to leave that to everybody else. But, yeah, DMX is in here. We couldn't practice in here, you know, because DMX has a show tonight. But I don't know. All I know about DMX, didn't he help Exhibit with X Gonna Give It To You with
of
that
course,
song?
Yes.
Right. So, like, when I was at GW, Xavier was one of our biggest rivalries, and we had to hear that song in warm-ups all the time. That's about the, you know,
most, you know,
extent of my knowledge.
I started playing. There's no way.
I started playing songs today in the office, and I had to hit stop really quick because they were the unedited versions. It's bad.
it is weird. So normally we're up on the concourse. I'm happy where we are. It's beautiful here in the atrium, but you don't even get to practice on your court because there's a concert tonight. It's a little odd.
Well, you say it's our court. Yeah, it's our home game. We'll be wearing white tomorrow. But we played Howard down here earlier this year, coming back from Thanksgiving. So we have played in here once. We love it down here. Our kids love it. They get excited for it because, you know, when it starts filling in, it's a great environment. And Siena's got great fans. So, you know, I think we got a shot at this game this year. You know, I felt good about it last year. Some calls didn't go our way down the stretch. But, you know, it's not really necessarily how I feel. Honestly, guys, I just love coaching this team right now. We were down at Hofstra, and we were up 10 at the end of the third, got down one, and our team just didn't quit, and we came back. And out at Colgate, we were down 13, came back, won in overtime. So, you know, we dropped a tough one at Rutgers, lost by 12, but we played well, and the kids were, you know, had a chance to play against Vivian Stringer, which she's the only coach to ever coach three teams to a Final Four. She's closing in on 1,000 wins. I'm one of them. So I love our team this year. I just left practice, and they were all fired up and getting extra shots up. And, you know, I don't know. I don't know what tomorrow's going to hold, but I know you're going to see a Siena team that's going to go out and play their butts off and try to bring home that cup for the first time in however many years.
Man, Coach Al Jaques, we love you. And if you get in trouble for this interview, just blame Goz.
Yeah, go ahead, Coach.
That's what I always do.
Just point the finger. You know, when you point the finger, you got a bunch of other fingers coming back right at you. You know that, right?
Yeah, but I get that all the time. And usually it's only one. Best of luck tomorrow.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for joining us again. And we definitely are going to keep bothering you throughout the season.
Sounds awesome. Go Saints.